York Racecourse has seen many changes to its ground, with the first grandstand built back in 1754. This year, the main focus has been to transform the county stand, and it's due to be finished for the Dante Festival on the 16th of May.
Well, of course, a lot of the work we do every winter is about sprucing up and keeping on top of things, so that everything is freshly painted and the grass trimmed, and you can see behind us the flowers are starting to go in. So we grow them ourselves in a racecourse nursery, and they get put in just about this time of year, what, the 20-25 days ahead of the season. The most obvious project that people will notice coming back for the 2018 season will be the work we've done in the infield, in the middle of the course. We've given it a new name to reflect what people think of it: the picnic enclosure. So we used to call it the course enclosure. This year we're going to call it the picnic enclosure because that's exactly what it is. About £4 or 5 million, depending on quite what you include, has gone into the picnic enclosure. So a significant investment. We hope that'll see it fit for the 21st century. Two big new toilet blocks which are coming together. Additional pathways, because we're conscious people come with buggies, people come with wheelchairs. So as well as having the big grassed areas, just a little bit easier to get around inside the grassed areas. You're welcome to come down with your rug, even a few collapsible picnic chairs as well, and really enjoy, we hope, a great day's sport. You can get right up to the action. On the infield, you can stand right next to the winning post.
Recently, it was named Racecourse of the Year, and now the team feel they need to maintain the standards.
That just means the bar gets set higher for the 2018 season, so we need to keep investing in the experience. It's true of every visitor attraction, of every hotel, every restaurant people visit. To stay ahead, you need to keep making sure you're innovative, whether that's with the fresh twist on the menus. We're very proud of being in Yorkshire's larder, so using all the local ingredients, but the chefs have spent the winter looking at that. And in terms of physical things, it's a cycle. We spent the money here on the northern end 2 or 3 years ago where we're standing. This time round, it's in the picnic enclosure for those racegoers. There'll be investment as well in the grandstand and paddock areas.
Well-known artists are set to perform throughout the season, and their first headline act is Paloma Faith, who will be playing on the 30th of June.
It's a chance to perhaps reach out to a slightly wider audience. Each of those events have got some great racing as well. People do arrive in time to engage with the racing and to have a little flutter and to see how magnificent the thoroughbreds are. But, you know, big name music acts were a little bit a long way away from any of the really big arenas here in York. So we hope we fill a little bit of a gap, albeit in an outdoor arena sense, of providing maybe more that festival atmosphere in terms of standing in front of a big stage with the big screens and the outdoor music decks. So that's very much the feel of those music events. We hope we'll be blessed with a little bit more sunshine as we go through the three of them.
With the investments put in place for new facilities and famous acts to perform, the ground is set to see fit for both jockeys and racegoers this season. Rebecca Quarmby, That's TV.